Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Hyperparameter tuning is an important optimization step for building a good topic model. BERTopic is a topic modeling Python library that combines transformer embeddings and clustering model algorithms to identify topics in NLP. In this tutorial, we will talk about what are the hyperparameters for the BERTopic model, how to tune the hyperparameters for the topic model, how to compare the results with different hyperparameter values. Please check out my previous tutorial topic modeling with deep learning using Python BERTopic for an introduction to BERTopic. Let's get started. In step one, we will install and import Python libraries. Firstly, let's import BERTopic and Flare. After the installation, when we try to import the BERTopic method, a type error about an unexpected keyword argument cacheadir came up. This type error is caused by the incompatibility between joblib and HDBSCAN. At the time this tutorial was created, joblib has a new release that is not supported by HDBSCAN. HDBSCAN does have a fix for it but has not been rolled out. So if you are watching this tutorial on YouTube or reading this tutorial on medium.com at a later time, you may not encounter this error message. Before the incompatibility issue between joblib and HDBSCAN is fixed, we can solve this issue by installing an old version of joblib. In this example, we use joblib version 1.1.0. After installing joblib, we need to restart the runtime. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. UMAP and PCA are for dimension reduction. HDBSCAN and K-means are for clustering models. Count vectorizer is for term vectorization. Sentence transformers and Flare are for pre-trained document embeddings. BERTopic is for the topic modeling. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. The second step is to download and read the dataset. The UCI Machine Learning Repository has the review data from three websites, mdb.com, amazon.com, and yelp.com. We will use the review data from amazon.com for this tutorial. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to the UCI website sentiment labeled sentences page. 2. Click data folder. 3. Download sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 4. Unzip sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 5. Copy the file Amazon cells labeled .txt to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I set the default directory to the folder where the review dataset is saved. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. Now let's read the data into a pandas data frame and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has two columns. One column contains the reviews and the other column contains the sentiment label for the review. Since this tutorial is for topic modeling, we will not use the sentiment label column, so we removed it from the dataset. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 1,000 records and no missing data. The review column is the object type. In step 3, we will talk about the hyperparameters for dimensionality reduction in BERTopic. Dimensionality reduction is necessary because the clustering model works better for low-dimension data than high-dimension data. The document embeddings usually have hundreds of dimensions, so we need to reduce the dimensionality before passing the embeddings to a clustering model. The default algorithm for dimension reduction is UMAP. Compared with other dimension reduction techniques such as PCA, UMAP maintains the data's local and global structure when reducing the dimensionality, which is important for representing the semantics of the text data. The UMAP model accepts customized hyperparameters. NNeighbors is the local neighborhood size for UMAP. This is the parameter that controls the local versus global structure in data. A low value forces UMAP to focus more on the local structure, and may lose insights into the big picture. A high value pushes UMAP to look at the broader neighborhoods and may lose details on local structure. This usually results in a larger cluster size. The default NNeighbors value for UMAP is 15. NComponents indicates the output dimension for UMAP. This is the dimension of data that will be passed into the clustering model. MinDist controls how tightly UMAP is allowed to pack points together. It is the minimum distance between points in the low-dimensional space. Small values of MinDist result in clumpier embeddings, which is good for clustering. Since our goal of dimension reduction is to build clustering models, we set min-dist to 0. Large values of min-dist prevent UMAP from packing points together and preserves the broad structure of data. Metric equals cosine indicates that we will use cosine to measure the distance. Random state sets a random C to make the UMAP results reproducible. BERTopic model by default produces different results each time because of the stochasticity inherited from UMAP. To get reproducible topics, we need to pass a value to the random state parameter in the UMAP method. After initiating the UMAP model with the hyperparameters, we pass it to the BERTopic model and run the model using the review data. Using the attribute getTopicInfo on the topic model gives us a list of topics. We can see that the output gives us 25 rows in total. Topic minus 1 should be ignored. It indicates that the reviews are not assigned to any specific topic. The count for topic minus 1 is 277, meaning that there are 277 outlier reviews that do not belong to any topic. Topic 0 to topic 23 are the 24 topics created for the reviews. It was ordered by the number of reviews in each topic, so topic 0 has the highest number of reviews. The name column lists the top terms for each topic. For example, the top 4 terms for topic 0 are sound, hear, quality, and the, indicating that it is a topic related to sound quality. BERTopic provides the option of using other dimensionality reduction techniques by changing the UMAP model value in the BERTopic method. For example, we can use the widely used dimension reduction algorithm PCA to replace UMAP. The output shows that 5 topics are created, which is much less than the 24 topics using UMAP. In step 4, we will talk about the hyperparameters for the clustering model in BERTopic. After the text documents have been transformed into embeddings, and the embeddings dimensionality has been reduced, the next step is to run a clustering model on the embedded documents. The default algorithm for clustering is HDBSCAN. HDBSCAN is a density-based clustering model. It identifies the number of clusters automatically and does not require specifying the number of clusters beforehand like most of the clustering models. HDBSCAN has a few important hyperparameters. Min cluster size is the minimum number of documents in each cluster. A larger minimum cluster size results in bigger clusters and fewer total clusters. A smaller minimum cluster size results in smaller clusters and a larger number of total clusters. A rule of thumb is to increase this threshold for a large dataset, and keep it at the default value of 10 for a small dataset. Min samples controls the number of outliers. It defaults to the same value as min cluster size. Reducing the value helps to reduce the noise in the topics. Metric indicates the distance metric used for the clustering model such as Euclidean. Prediction data is for new documents topic predictions. We need to set it to false if there is no need for new document prediction. After specifying the hyperparameters for the HDBSCAN model, we pass the model into the BERTopic method. Notice that when initiating the BERTopic model, the UMAP model from the previous step is passed in as well. This is because we would like to utilize the same random seed defined in the UMAP model to make the results comparable. We will include UMAP model for all the topic models going forward. Besides the HDBSCAN clustering model, BERTopic supports other clustering algorithms. There are two major differences between HDBSCAN and other clustering algorithms such as K-means and GMM. HDBSCAN creates a separate cluster for outliers, but most other algorithms do not, so the clusters may contain more noise than HDBSCAN clusters. HDBSCAN automatically decides the number of clusters, while most other clustering algorithms need to have the number of clusters as input. To learn more about the clustering model, please check out my previous tutorials 5 ways for deciding number of clusters and 4 clustering model algorithms in Python. We provide the sample code to implement a K-means clustering model with BERTopic, and other clustering model algorithms can follow the same process. Firstly, the K-means model is initiated with the number of clusters. Then the initiated K-means model is passed into the HDBSCAN model parameter in the BERTopic function. After that, the BERTopic model is fit and we get a list of 15 topics. In step 5, we will talk about how to tune the language embeddings. Embeddings are the vector representation of the documents. BERTopic uses the English version of the sentence transformer by default to get document embeddings. If there are multiple languages in the document, we can use BERTopic language equals multilingual to support the topic modeling of over 50 languages. On the backend, the language parameter in the BERTopic method uses the sentence transformer model. When language equals English, the sentence transformer model AllMinLML6v2 is used. When language equals multilingual, the sentence transformer model paraphrase multilingual MinLML12v2 is used. Sentence transformer has different models with different sizes, speeds, and performances. We can go to the sentence transformer website for the latest list of pre-trained models. We can select any model from sentence transformers and pass it through BERTopic with the embedding model parameter. For example, to use the sentence transformer model paraphrase AlbertSmallv2, we can pass it onto the sentence transformer and set it as the embedding model. The output gives us 21 topics, and the topics look similar to the topics from the default parameters. Besides the sentence transformer models, BERTopic supports the pre-trained models from other Python packages such as Hugging Face and Flare. Hugging Face Model Hub has thousands of pre-trained models. In this example, we used an English model called DistilRoboDBase, loaded it in a Hugging Face pipeline, and passed the pipeline to the parameter embedding model. We can see that two topics are created, and the terms are not very meaningful, indicating that DistilRoboDBase is not a good choice for our review corpus. Flare is an NLP library that allows us to choose almost any embedding models, or combine a few embedding models together. To use a single embedding model with Flare, we can pass the model name to Transformer Document Embeddings, and use it as the input for the embedding model option in BERTopic. We can see that two topics are created, and all the terms are stopwords without much meaning, indicating that this is not a good embedding model choice for our review corpus. To use multiple embedding models with Flare, we first need to initiate different pre-trained embedding models, then use the stacked embeddings function to stack the models, and finally pass the stacked embeddings to the BERTopic embedding model parameter. We can see that 14 topics are created. The results look better than just using one model, but still not as good as the sentence transformer embedding models. In step 6, we will talk about how to change the number of topics for the topic model. BERTopic uses the number of clusters created by the HDBSCAN model as the number of topics by default, but we can reduce the number of topics by changing the value of the NRTopics parameter. NRTopics equals none indicates that there is no topic reduction. NRTopics equals auto indicates an automatic topic reduction of the HDBSCAN results by merging topics close to each other. NRTopics equals 15 indicates that the target number of topics is 15. NRTopics value should always be smaller than the number of topics created by NRTopics equals none. On the backend, the topic reduction process is executed by merging similar topics based on the feature vector from CTF-IDF. It starts with low-frequency topics and iteratively reduces the number of topics to the specified number. After setting NRTopics equals 15, we can see that the BERTopic model produced 15 topics. When the text corpus is large, training a BERTopic model can take a long time. Rerunning the model each time we change the number of topics can waste a lot of time and resources. The good news is that the BERTopic package has a reduce topics method that uses the existing model information to do a topic reduction. After passing in the review corpus and the number of topics, we can see that the number of topics is reduced to the specified number of 10. If we would like to manually pick which topics to merge together based on domain knowledge, we can list the topic numbers and pass them into the merge topics function. In this example, we merge topic 0 and topic 3 together because they both talk about headphone quality, and merge topic 2 and topic 6 together because they both talk about product satisfaction. The number of topics is reduced by 2, and we have 8 topics now. Another way of adjusting the number of topics is to control the minimum number of documents in a topic. We can set up this value by the parameter min topic size. A low value for min topic size allows fewer documents to form a topic, so the topic model produces more topics. A high value for min topic size requires a lot of documents to form a topic, so the topic model produces fewer topics. The default value for min topic size is 10. A general guideline for setting min topic size is to set up a low value for a smaller dataset, and a high value for a larger dataset. Setting min topic size is the same as setting min cluster size in HDBSCAN. We can see that after setting the minimum topic size of 25, we get fewer topics, and each topic has more than 25 documents. In step 7, we will tune the hyperparameter for the top words representing the topics. The parameters that we will talk about are n-gram range and top n words. N-gram range is used to specify the range of n-grams included in the topic model. Top n words controls how many words are used to describe the topic. Let's take a look at n-gram range first. N-grams are a continuous sequence of words. Its value determines the words used in count vectorizer, and the top words representing the topics. Unigram refers to one word. Unigram is the default for BERTopic. Bigram refers to two consecutive words. For example, ice cream is considered as one word for bigram, but will be separated into two words, ice and cream for unigram. Trigram refers to three consecutive words. Cardinal numbers are used for more than three consecutive words, 4-gram, 5-gram, for example. N-gram range equals 1 to 3 means that unigrams, bigrams, and trigrams are included in the model. From the output, we can see that the keywords representing the topics include both single words and multi-word phrases. Next, let's talk about top n words. Top n words has the default value of 10, meaning that 10 top words will be used to represent each topic. If we change the value to 5, only the top 5 most representative words are included. In step 8, we will talk about how to control the number of words for the topic model. Limiting the number of words helps to reduce the noise in the topics. There are two ways to control how many words are used in Count Vectorizer and CTF-IDF. MinDF sets a threshold for the required word frequency. For example, MinDF equals 10 indicates that any words that appeared less than 10 times in the corpus will not be included in the CTF-IDF calculation. A general guideline is to set a high MinDF value for a large corpus and a low value for a small corpus. Max features indicates the maximum number of words to include for the CTF-IDF calculation. Max features equals 1000 means that the top 1000 words with the highest frequency in the corpus will be included. Both MinDF and Max features are the hyperparameters for the count vectorizer. To use MinDF, we set the value when initiating count vectorizer, then pass it to the vectorizer model argument in the BERTopic method. To use max features, we set the value when initiating count vectorizer, then pass it to the vectorizer model argument in the BERTopic method. In step 9, we will tune the hyperparameter to achieve a more diversified topic representation. The top n words that represent the topic may include variations of the same word or words that are synonyms. The hyperparameter diversity helps to remove the words with the same or similar meanings. It has a range of 0 to 1, where 0 means least diversity and 1 means most diversity. After setting diversity equals 0.8, we can see that the top words describing the topics are more diversified. For example, topic 13 previously has the top words disappointed, very disappointment, disappointing, and has the top words disappointment, aggravating, yao, displeased after diversification, which is much more diversified. In step 10, we will talk about how to remove the stopwords from the list of the top words. After creating the topics, if the top words representing the topics contain stopwords, we can remove the stopwords using stopwords equals English with count vectorizer. We can see that after using stopwords equals English, all the stopwords are removed from the top keywords. In step 11, we will talk about the Boolean parameter that decides whether or not to produce topic probability. When calculate probabilities equals true, the probabilities of each document belonging to each topic are calculated. The topic with the highest probability is the predicted topic for a new document. This probability represents how confident we are about finding the topic in the document. When calculate probabilities equals false, the probabilities of each document belonging to each topic are not calculated. This saves computation time and cost. If there is no new document to predict, we do not need to calculate the probabilities. We can visualize the probabilities using visualized distribution and pass in the document index. Visualized distribution has the default probability threshold of 0.015, so only the topic with a probability greater than 0.015 will be included. The topic probability distribution for the first review in the dataset shows that topic 7 has the highest probability, so topic 7 is the predicted topic. The first review is so there is no way for me to plug it in here in the US unless I go buy a converter. And the topic of plugging a charger is pretty relevant. We can also get the predicted probability for all topics using the code below. We can see that there are 24 probability values, one for each topic. Index 7 has the highest value, indicating that topic 7 is the predicted topic. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about the natural language processing models, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.